which we have studied till now, they always help us to branch to one or the other place within the loop itself. The looping instruction, that is while or a do while or a for, they will always branch to the respective keyword after executing some set of statements. For example, when I say while, as soon as I complete the last instruction of this particular while statement block, it will always go back and reconnect to the while keyword. In a do while, the condition when it is tested with while, if it is true, it will execute the statements which are there in that and connect back to the do keyword. So a do while loop will always, between a do and while, a for is always for a block of statement, and a while is again for a block of statements. Within that, we can place some conditions. And if you want to terminate the loop in the mid of its operation, in that case, what you can do is, you can use a break keyword. A break will branch you to the instruction which appear outside of the loop. If somewhere in the loop, if a break instruction gets executed, always take the control outside the loop and starts executing the remaining instructions of this particular part. Hence, we call all these as structured instruction, because we know where exactly we are going to land and how this particular entire operation goes within the programming part. Hence, we call all these as conditional control instruction, because they are going to occur or they are going to repeat for some finite number of times until a specific condition remains true. Once the condition turns out as false, it will always quit. Can I branch to a program unconditionally? I don't want to check any condition. As soon as I execute this, I have to go back to one specific place, or I have to go ahead at one specific place. Yes, C language has got this particular provision where you can make the program to flow directly away from this particular loop and reach to an unknown place. Not at the end of the loop, reach to an unknown place. That instruction is called as go to. But it is not advisable to go into this particular instruction every time in the practical aspects. Probably, the more you understand this particular go to instruction, you might say that this is more handy. But try to avoid using this particular instruction more frequently. This will say that the programming operations are not structured. You will go in an unstructured way, because you can ignore some set of instruction, and when excessive good instructions are used, you will always land at some place by either repetitively doing the operation infinite times, or you might ignore some set of instructions permanently, even though they might appear physically in the code. How that is going to work? Let us see the practical syntax of this particular good instruction. So the good instruction goes in this fashion. The keyword is go to, followed by something called as a label. Where do I get this particular label? So the label, wherever you want to use this particular label one more time, you have to write this particular label followed by a colon instruction. There is no specific place where you can write this particular label. You can write this particular label either at the beginning, at the end, in the mid, any place of your choice. What this label is? Label is any valid identifier name. No declaration of this particular label, right? Suppose if I have an instruction called as go to. Go to is one keyword. Go to, I'll say L1, semicolon. Now, whenever this instruction is executed, what it does is, it will transfer the control directly to a place where this L1 appears. Irrespective of the number of instructions which appear, I'll always say L1. So, when this instruction is executed, it will ignore these instructions permanently and transfer the control directly to this particular place and again start executing the instructions ahead of this. Clear? Okay. Now, if goto is not used with proper precaution, what might happen? And will this goto work like a break instruction? Let's check this. Suppose if I have a while loop at this place, while I'll say C1. Somewhere in this, I'll say if C2, I'll say break. This is the instruction which is outside the loop, and this is the remaining program, right? Now, how this works? When the condition is true, when C1 is true, it will enter inside the loop. And if C2 is false, it executes the remaining instructions of the loop and then go back to C1. So a loop keeps on repeating when C1 is true. And in any case, in this mid of operation, if C2 is true, what it does is it takes break instruction. And this break will transfer the control outside the loop, which means that we are making some part of the loop being isolated permanently. Can I use a break as an alternate of good? You can, provided that the label is placed exactly outside the loop. Suppose if I say while C1, if C2, I'll say go to L1, ignore the loop, and outside this you'll say L1 and then the remaining code. Very good. You can now say that this go to L1 is a perfect replacement for break. Because when I say go to L1, it is going to go to a place where L1 reappears. But by mistake, if this L1 is placed somewhere ahead of this particular code, what happens? A break will always take you to the next instruction which appears outside the loop. But when I say go to L1, and if L1 is placed somewhere outside, this will automatically take the control L1 outside this particular part, thus ignoring some set of instructions permanently. Hence, it is not advisable to use go to as a replacement for break. If you are going to take utmost care, then only you can go for go to instruction. A go to is said to be an unconditional transfer instruction. In some cases, you might feel this as more handy, but try to avoid using this particular go-to on a regular basis. This is how we use the concepts of go-to instruction. So any program which you have written using break or using continue instruction can be replaced with this particular go-to, provided that you place the label exactly outside the loop. You can use this label even at the beginning of the code, in the mid, in the end, any place of your choice, no restriction on that. So wherever the label reappears, the control is going to transfer unconditionally to that particular place whenever the condition is going to occur. That is about the concepts of go-to instructions.